What's it mean? I mean, I think you do have the best team in boxing. What's that mean to you to have that depth of wisdom and talent around you to call upon no matter what situation is going on in your career, in your life, in anything?
You know, where I come from, it's like not my age group, but like people like Calvin, Floyd, and Barry, they had that OG. You know what I mean? My generation, they really didn't really look up to OGs. But I feel as though I was blessed to have people that, you know, that's been through a lot. You know, everybody on the stage been through different stuff. You know what I mean? So I feel as though I'm blessed to have that, you know, these guys that's walking that path with me. You know, so I definitely want to thank each and one of these guys that, you know, even when I, you know, sometimes I don't listen. I mean, I'm my own man, so I want to make my own mistakes. But it is what it is. I definitely appreciate it.
Take every day I wake up, somebody else calls you out. It doesn't matter their weight class. They could be super middleweight, 135, 140. Sometimes you respond, sometimes you don't. But do you see all that?
I mean, that's what it is.
Why? Why are they calling you out?
Floyd, in the All Access, he threw a little shade at Tank about his basketball game, saying he wasn't making a lot of shots. But
I did.
But they did. Yeah, they said that just that day.
Yeah, I throw shade.
No,
throw shade.
They was throwing shade.
A little bit.
Not you.
He was missing a couple buckets.
Right. Tank said it was a bad day. Did you? Have you played with Tank? And are you? Is he going to be on the Manny Pacquiao team that you take to face against Manny Pacquiao?
I don't know if he's going to go over there and play. He can go over there and play on my team. Get him out.
Tank, you're on a long string of KOs right now. Talk to me about that.
Yeah, go ahead.
Tank, you're on a long string of KOs right now. Talk to me about the anatomy of throwing that knockout shot. Are you throwing these punches unconsciously? It seems like lightning bolts just coming out of nowhere sometimes. Where do these shots come from?
They come from your hands, don't
they? I don't know. Just, you know, I've been doing it for so long. It just, it's second nature. I don't think I've been trying to, like, throw with bad attention every time. It just come off like that.
Do you have a favorite knockout you have achieved so far?
Leo.
Which one is it? Leo?
Yeah.
Why is that?
We're
not gonna tell you that. I told you that. Hold on. I just told you we're not gonna tell you the game plan. No, we're not gonna do that.
Were you surprised
that
that
shit come with the territory. It's the fight game. You win some, you lose some.
You done it?
Shit, I lost some worse than that. I lost my children's mother. So shit, we like I just said before, you don't always got to not, you can have a loss, but it don't always have to be in the ring. So we have losses through our life. So, you know, like I said before, you go through ups and downs in life. You win some, you lose some, but you know, we live and we keep fighting just through our life.
Speaking of inside and out the ring, Leonard, you mentioned earlier while you were up there talking about Tank is that Tank seems to be getting it together both inside the ring and outside the ring. Can you elaborate a little bit on that for us, sir?
Well, did you guys get a chance to see the podcast that he did? This is the first in-depth interview that he's given that where the fans got a chance to see a different side of him. I mean, if you just go and you look. Look at how many views that interview has gotten. These are the kind of things we think outside of the box to cross them over. It's no shade against you guys, but you guys kind of just ask the same old routine, ordinary questions. And it was a chance to...
Hold on. Shit, ain't too many questions they can ask. Shit, they ain't never fought before.
Yeah.
So most time motherfuckers doing an interview, you know, these boxing so-called, you know, like they got all the guys that's commentating for the fights. I'm like, yo, now... Timothy Bradley do a good job, and Andre Ward, both of those guys do a good job, but a lot of people, and I appreciate you guys covering boxing, but a lot of times you guys only can ask the questions that they ask because they don't really know nothing about boxing, for real. I'm going to say like Roger Mayweather, they really don't know shit about boxing.
But it was a good opportunity to see a different side of him. And in my personal opinion, I think it was the best interview he's ever done that I personally witnessed.
What?
The interview you did on the podcast?
Oh, yeah.
It's fire. It's fire.
There's things I didn't even know.
Really, really good.
Are you finding more comfort in doing that and opening up and really, like the things you just said earlier?
I mean, I'm just overall with the sport, I'm getting more comfortable, opening up a little bit. At first, I was a kid off the block. But I'm maturing as a fighter, as a person.